guys, it's Haff. I am back again, and it is time for September's makeup basket. I am a bit late this month. I have already used this makeup once and a bit. Not much this month, because I'm not really going out much, so I should make more effort, but I'm not. So the theme for this month is spicy. I don't have a lot of products that are actually spicy related. There's a whole bunch of stuff that is just makeup that I'm using this particular month, but I will do what I normally do and go through everything from the start to the finish. Yes, my hair has just been done, so if you notice colour, it's just from my hair. And nice fresh undercut. Most people don't even realise I have one because I have so much hair. But yeah, I've actually had it taken up a tiny bit higher. But yes, fresh colour. So I'm going to start with the Australis See You Later Pores. This is in one of my projects. I mentioned that it is like the Porefessional. So it is like that. It has this kind of weird texture. Reminds me a little bit of porridge. What Americans probably think more of as oatmeal. I use it mainly through my T-zone because that is where I have the most texture on my skin. I probably squeezed out too much. I also have this weird spot here. When I did my Bella Box unboxing, I got these Subu pimple spot things, and I'm like, I'm not going to use those. Like, I don't get zits enough to need that. I'll just, like, give them to my daughter. Oh, I got this beastie up here, and then I got this beastie down here, and they make them less obvious. So like this one here, I actually put one on and then I put makeup over the top of it, or sort of around it. And it was a lot less noticeable than it would have been if I hadn't. It sort of stops you from really being able to see the redness so much. I don't know how foundation lays over the top of it because I haven't actually tried that. It probably doesn't. Probably just makes it more obvious. But yeah, if you sort of see this weird spot on my face, that's what it is. I've been getting these, like, little cystic acnes, and they're driving me crazy. So, the foundation I'm using this month is the Revlon Youth Effects. I have it in two colours, ivory and porcelain. I wore this to uni the other day, and whilst it didn't look terrible, it didn't last all day. And I actually set it with powder, which I don't normally do, and it still didn't last all day. It is a very thick formula. Show you on the back of my hand the difference between the colours. They're both a bit more yellow than I would like. But yes, they don't, it started like breaking apart, particularly through here, by the end of the day. And it wasn't even a 12-hour day. I just noticed it as I was, when I got home, I was like, ugh, I look terrible. And yes, using my fish brush, which I love. I don't know that it is the best for applying this, and I realise it looks terrible, right? Give me a chance. I had already, moisturised my skin before I started. I don't usually show that because I use the same serum, eye gel, and moisturizer every single day. Two of which are Aldi products, and one is the Olay, not the Total Effects, just the one in the white bottle. It's looking terrible on my forehead right now. And I didn't do the sides of my nose yet, great job. I have my beauty blender standing by. This is not looking like in the camera you can't tell. But it's not looking best. For something that is supposed to make you look youthful, it looks kinda heavy. In my opinion. I probably put a bit too much on, but whatever. And I was right, it just makes the pimple spot look more obvious. But the pimple spot thing protects it from the makeup. So there's that. I love how pasty I always look when I first put on foundation. It's great. I look gorgeous. Concealer, I'm using the Fit Me Concealer in 05 Ivory, which you have seen multiple times. Ooh. So this is literally my second time wearing the what is that? Revlon, whatever it's called, foundation. For my eyebrows, I am using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Powder Duo in Caramel. This stuff will never end. I will have it until I am 80. My eyebrows are covered in foundation, so I gather all of my American subscribers and watchers are all super excited for Halloween. I'm just super excited for weather that is not cold and wet. And every time we think that the worst of the wintry weather is over, we get another blast of winter, just to remind us that it's not summer yet. Spring in Australia is pretty much a couple of days of really nice weather, followed by a couple of days of horrendous weather. And it just repeats like that for 3 months. That's pretty much how it works. Blend this concealer. I heard there's a new foundation out that has what they call it, flex technology. So it's supposed to flex with your facial features, so you shouldn't get lines and stuff like that. I'd like to test it just to see whether it can deal with this up here, because I'm quite expressive and I always end up with huge creases across my forehead because I raise my eyebrows a lot, which causes lines across your forehead. Usually because I'm just really surprised at the stuff that I see on a daily basis. Looking a little bit better now. It doesn't look great when it goes on, but it seems to settle down. Except, of course, on my forehead, where it always just, everything just looks like shit. Literally just because I can't keep my forehead still long enough for makeup to set properly before I mess it up. I do not possess the ability to stop my eyebrows from moving up and down. I'm going to use some extender brow today to build up the eyebrows a bit. It's literally just a fiber thing. Makes them a little bit darker and gives them a bit more body, as I have big gaps in my brows. I'd love to get my brows microbladed so I actually have eyebrows. And to finish them off, I'm going to use some Browless Way, which is the Rimmel brow gel. This is in blonde. I mostly use stuff that's in blonde because I don't want them too dark. Although that extender brow stuff is in light medium because it only comes in two colorways. So. Okay, eyebrows are done. I'm going to set underneath my eyes, which I've already started creasing because I have lines under my eyes. I'm not like 20 years old anymore. I'm just using a white powder. Yes, one might needs to make sure one blends it properly, otherwise it looks terrible in flash photography. I'm also going to put some powder on the rest of my face. This is the Physician's Formula Mineral Finishing Veil, which I have been trying to use up now for maybe 2 years. It's just it doesn't work with all foundations when you've got kind of dry skin like I've got, well, starting to get. So, I have to use it pretty sparingly. So it takes a while to use. And brush off my white. I don't bake because that makes me look cakey. And I've heard a lot of other people saying very similar things. Now I just look really powdery, but we will fix that in a bit. Next, we are going to get into I'm going to do a little bit of contour because I want to try this contour brush which I haven't tried yet. This is the Pro Contour from Urban Studio, which I picked up online. I'm just going to use some Haffina from Australia. Is way more obvious in the camera than it is in person. Let's do some jawline, even though the purple is really distracting on my neck. I does. Alright. That's not fun thing about. Alright. For blush, I have two choices. I have the blush in the 3D contour kit from LA Colors that I have. The contour is clearly not my colour. It's actually got a red undertone to it, which is really weird. This is called Hottie, sort of goes with the spicy thing. My two blushes are actually quite similar, so that's clearly a blush. And then the other one is Love Affair, usually a little spicy, from Makeup Geek, which is quite bright. I think I used Love Affair the other day. So I think I'm going to use this one from the LA Girls Power, because it doesn't even look like it's been touched. Okay, even when I put my brush in it, it doesn't look like it's been touched. There's purple on my skin over here, which is throwing me off when I look in the mirror and in the camera. Okay, so that's all of them bits done. For highlighter, I actually only have, other than the one that's in the contour kit, which is not a very good highlighter, the only one I put in is Lit, which is sort of spicy. From Pretty for Your Face. So that's what I'm using. It's kind of peachy. It's kind of got a spicy look to it. That's what I'm going with. The Pretty for Your Face highlighters are bomb. Absolutely amazing. It does love them. All my other highlighters are getting neglected because I have these. And a touch on the nose. And the coupe of the bow. And the chin. Blendy blend. Okay. Now I'm going to use the NYX Dewy Finish thinning spray. Primer this month, I am using the LA Girl Pro Primer in white. You've been watching me, you know I've been alternating between the nude and the white of the LA Girl Pro Primers all year this year. Just gotta blend that out. I've already got foundation on my eyelids as well, so pretty much primed and ready to go. So, now for eyeshadows and eyeshadow palettes, I have a few options. I could use the contour and highlighter from the blush palette if I got really desperate. I have a cream eyeshadow from Natio. This is in cinnamon. I used this the other day. It's actually not very good. I may declutter that. I've got a hair on my face and it's annoying me. I have from LA Colors, I have this eyeshadow palette, which you can't see all of in frame. It is the Smoky palette, which is basically exactly what it sounds like. It is a smoky palette. So I'm going to use... Okay, so I'm going to set the primer with this white that's... It's kind of an off-white, but it's... just to give me a base to blend other shadows on. The other day I basically did the cinnamon with, I think it was this colour in the crease, because I was doing something really simple. It didn't end up being so simple, it just ended up being quite a smoky eye even without me trying. But today I'm going to do something a little different, because the other two eyeshadows I have in here are from my Girly Cosmetics palette, and they are chili pepper, which is the red one, and this one is lemon zest. So I'm going to use those, and I'm also going to use some of the glitter that I put in, which is called Fire Eater from Glamadol Eyes. So I'm going to use that as well. So, to start off with, I'm actually going to take some of the Haffina contour shade, which was sitting in the palette with the other two. Just want to put a bit of something down first. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to put yellow through here as well, and then I'm going to do red on the lid and then some glitter, or I might halo it. I don't know, I haven't really decided. So I'm going to start with the yellow. It is a bit powdery. And I'm just going to take my time building it up. It's slightly shimmery, but if you've been watching me for a while, you'll know that I don't ascribe to the don't put shimmers in your crease thing. Use what you've got, do what you want with it. You'll work out what looks best for you. I don't generally use yellow a lot because I'm quite pink, which is part of the reason for putting a little bit of brown underneath, just to neutralize it a little. I was going to get my hair yellow, but I've got to be careful which color yellow I pick, otherwise it just looks weird. I was literally going to get my hair done like a pineapple, but I decided I might do a purple pineapple instead, maybe next time. Because my hairdresser's keen to cut into my hair and make a pineapple grid on the back of my head. Okay, I'm going to go into chili pepper. There's one of those colours that it is best to start small and build up. looks quite pink in the camera at the moment. But it's more a base for, although it has gold glitter in it itself, it's more a base for the glitter. I'm going to take the yellow again. I'm going to go over that line. Fully expecting it to go kind of a little orange there, which is fine. I'm going to take some black liquid eyeliner. This is just the La Cura one, because trying to put black eyeliner on after you put glitter on is problematic. I'm also going to do my tight lining before I do glitter. Just going to tight line with my Lancome Noir. Okay, so I have some glitter glue or glitter primer. This is the Essence Get Your Glitter On. I'm just going to use a small brush. Put some on the back of my hat. Oop, I forgot. I gotta shake this one up. It goes everywhere if you don't. You just get this liquid stuff come out. Not ideal. Forget. I'm sure I've ruined the consistency of it by forgetting. I'm just going to press some on each eyelid. I'm not swiping because I don't really want to dislodge the eyeshadow underneath, so just pressing on works better. And then taking the same brush, I'm going to dip into the glitter. And then press it in. Again, you don't want to swipe, you will get fallout if you do that. What the hell is that? under the eye, I am going to take the, as you can see, the long comb literally transferred on one side all by itself. So I'm just going to even up the eyes here. And then I'm going to rub it right along the lash line. I'm going to take a brush and I'm going to slide that out slightly. I'm going to curl my lashes and apply two coats of the Essence, Purple Essence Lash Princess. And Clump Crusher on the bottom, as usual. And then I will be back to finish the rest of my face. Okay, so for lips, I have a few options. The only lip liner I have put in is the AOA Studios lip liner in Bounce, which is also in one of my projects. These don't sharpen very well. As you can see, it's purple, which is pretty much not gonna work. And the lipstick that pretty much goes with that is the Smoked Purple Matte Lipstick from MAC, which is a really dark. I wore that the other day. I do really like that. I also put in the Cosmic Metals from NYX in Electromagnetic. Just, you know, electricity is a bit spicy. Which is green. I also have Ginger Sparkle from NYX. Which is just a gloss. It's got a slight pink tinge to it. I have Fire from Lord Mary, which is actually one of my other projects as well. But it's also in this, which is an orange. I have the Revlon Matte Balm Lip Stain in Sultry, which is sort of like a rosy nudish sort of shade. And I have the Mums Prefer Lip Lacquer in Hot Sand, which is a very sticky but sheer lip gloss in a nude colour. And lastly, I put in the NYX Transforming Duo Chromatic Lipstick thing in Chill Chill, which on its own just kind of looks white, but when you put it over other stuff, it's kind of good. So I am going to use Fire from the Lord Mary. this all clashes beautifully with my hair at the moment. And then I'm going to top that with a little bit of the ginger sparkle. Is one possible look from my makeup basket for September. I will link, I know Lisa is doing this, so I will link her down below. I'm not sure if anybody else is doing it. But if you want to subscribe, click the bell button down there, click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I will at least heart your response, if not answer questions that you ask me. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya!